Free electricity for next 20 years, no power cuts, free food, free cooking gas, and free water. This house behind me is where all of these things are free. You don't believe me? We're back with another episode of Sustainable Homes, and this time we are in Chennai. We are here to meet a man named Solar Suresh. Interesting name, isn't it? His story is even more interesting than his name. So let's go meet him.
I've found various solutions. All the solutions are very, very simple. Anybody can do it, a common man can do it. There's no rocket science. It's economically feasible, practically doable. Technology is not rocket science, it's very, very simple, very simple. My house is almost 50 years old, December 1977, we constructed. But all these installations I've done one by one. My first one was rainwater harvesting, which I installed about 25 years ago. Then, as I said, January 2012, I installed my rooftop solar plant. I have a huge house, 4-bedroom hall kitchen, nearly 25 lights and 15 fans. February 2013, I installed my biogas plant, domestic biogas plant. Okay, the domestic biogas plant, there are different capacities are available. I've installed a 1 cubic meter capacity. I feed about 3 to 4 kg per day, but I don't feed it on a daily basis. I feed, depending on my convenience, mostly on a weekly basis. That's about 15-20 kgs waste per week. In the biogas, methane gas is produced. There's no pressure in the gas. Therefore, the cooking is a little slow. There's a separate stove for this. The burner holes are big. From the plant, I was getting the organic manure, so I started my terrace kitchen garden. By middle of 2013, I started that. Though I have the terrace for over 50 years, I didn't do anything. Only last 5-6 years, after installing the biogas, when I started getting the organic manure, I scratched my head. Why should I throw it? Why not I use it? So kept to use. I went on adding pots. Today I got nearly 150 pots. Because of humidity, there are a lot of moisture in the air. This is something like an air conditioner. There's a compressor which compresses this moisture in the air and produces the drinking water. It is as simple as that. I'm fond of giving two messages. A, do not expect the government to find the solutions for you. You find your own solutions. Finally, do not curse darkness. Light a candle. Light a solar.